This week marks the 2-year anniversary of this podcast. 104 episodes in 104 weeks, something that I initially thought I would not be capable of. As I've been approaching this 2-year mark, I've been thinking more about the current state of my podcast and where it's at now, and I've realized my energy for the podcast has changed since day one, and I don't quite feel the same way about it. In fact, I've even thought about quitting doing my podcast. When I think about why I have these thoughts, or when I start to actually processing why I want to quit the podcast, or what's the benefit of quitting the podcast, I really only end up coming up with excuses. There's never really any concrete reason for why I should be doing it. It would be different, say, if I got a job, or if I had brought on all this extra work, or if I had some other things going on. But I don't. I'm simply just kind of getting tired of the cycle of my podcast, but that doesn't mean I should stop doing it. It doesn't mean it's not a good thing for me. So to me, it kind of goes back a little bit to last week and how I spend my time. Although I may be tired of the routine of my podcast or whatever else, that doesn't mean I should quit it. It does a lot of good for me. In fact, there's a lot of episodes where I start grumpy and then I'll talk myself out of it by talking my through the situation. There's a lot of good my podcast does for me, so why quit it? There's no real benefit to quitting it. Although I would argue with myself, there's no real benefit to continuing it. It's not like I make any money off this podcast and like it gets me any social clout. It's not like I've made some cool connections through my podcast or anything. It hasn't really had any major benefit other than some sort of self-enrichment, which is a good thing, which is something to be gained regardless. So when I really think about quitting the podcast, I find myself just making a lot of excuses is what it really comes down to. But I really wonder, why am I making these excuses? They don't really help me in any way. They just cause more turmoil within myself and make things more complicated. So why do we make excuses? I don't really get it. This comes from the famed motivational speaker Tony Robbins' website. Excuses often come from 3 places: fear, uncertainty, and lack of purpose. Now, if we were to analyze me wanting to quit my podcast, I would say you almost immediately see all 3 of these factors. I'm afraid that I'm doing my podcast for no reason. There's no real benefit to it. I'm putting this time in my podcast and it's going nowhere. There's nothing coming out of it. There's nothing on the other end. There's no sort of end product other than just putting out the podcast each week. But I'm also uncertain with that, in that same sort of manner of like, what am I doing? Where is it going? What is the purpose of all that? As I'm talking about the second point, I bring up the third point even on accident. I'm uncertain that I'm even doing something good here. It doesn't feel like it's adding any benefit to my life. It doesn't feel like it's really helping me progress in my life at all. So with that, I also feel there's no real purpose to it. I'm just sort of doing it. I'm not working in any direction with it. I at one point had a goal of making money my podcast, but I don't care about that as much anymore. I kind of just care about doing what I want to do and doing what makes me happy. And at times, it doesn't feel like the podcast makes me happy, so I feel like I should stop doing it, but really, I just don't know where I'm going with it. A lot of time when people make excuses, they don't really know where they're going with it, so I thought it might be fun to take the time to take a look at some of the bigger excuses in history and try and figure out where the hell they were going with it. Politicians are a great example of some terrible excuse givers, and oftentimes they have to make excuses because their lives are in the public eye and people make mistakes, you know? And when you're in the public eye, you make mistakes, everybody sees it. So you have to make amends or try and reconcile your actions sometimes if you do something silly or wrong. Perhaps one of the most picture-perfect scandals to ever exist comes out of the United States House of Representatives from one member, Anthony Weiner. And I promise I'm not making his last name up. Anthony Weiner's Weiner scandal first began when he posted an image to Twitter that he was attempting to send to a 21-year-old college student of his Weiner in his boxers, half exposed and half erect. Now, naturally, as any person would when posed in a situation like this, he made excuses. He said, he was hacked! I was hacked! They got into my phone and they posed this picture! Come on, brother. Nobody's buying that. Your last name is Weiner. He was really fucked from day one. He had no luck at all.
The answer is I did not send that tweet. My system was hacked. I was pranked. It was a fairly common one. People make fun of my name all the time. When you name Weiner, you kind of get that.
Following his return to the public eye in 2013 in the mayoral race, he subsequently admitted to sexting more women and more pictures were released, and really his return was just met with more turmoil. But that wasn't the end. That wasn't the last we would hear of Anthony Weiner. As in 2016, during the most strenuous election that has ever happened in my life and that I know of in recent history, Hillary Clinton versus Donald Trump, Anthony Weiner was brought up in more controversy. Following a report from the Daily Mail, the FBI followed up on accusations that he had allegedly been in touch sexually with a 15-year-old girl. His laptop was seized, of course, and there were actually emails found in there relating to Hillary's email scandal. We won't get into that because who cares? It finally took after all of this time, after 5 years nearly, for his wife to finally realize after he pled guilty to one count of transferring obscene material to a minor, that maybe he wasn't cut out to be her husband, and she ultimately divorced him in 2017, despite being publicly embarrassed by her husband, whose last name is Weiner, for years on end. Good on you for finally leaving him, but maybe you should have noticed the writing on the wall.
Let me be clear. I am not gay. I never have been gay.
Another fantastic example of a miserable excuse comes from Idaho Senator Larry Craig. In 2007, he was arrested for lewd conduct in a Minneapolis airport bathroom. Now, when you hear that, you think, oh God, what did this guy do? Why did he wander his way into the ladies' restroom, and what did he do to that poor woman? Now, you'd be mistaken. He was arrested for soliciting sex by playing footsie with an undercover cop in a bathroom stall. Now, when you're caught in this kind of situation, what would be your immediate excuse? His was, well, I got wide stance to use the bathroom. I got to let my hog hang in the middle. Okay, Larry. That's what you went with? That's what you wanted to do? That's what you were trying to say to get out of this pickle? I got a wide stance in the bathroom. That was your angle, buddy? You worried about your hog in between your legs, when in reality, I think you were more worried about the feeling of another man's hog between your legs. Bad look, buddy. Not only is it a bad look for a senator, but he also was a traditionally social conservative, and he had championed a constitutional amendment to repeal gay marriage. So a man that wants to repeal gay marriage is very much gay himself. It's just funny the fact that a man that wanted to outlaw gay marriage clearly was seeking out the touch of a gay man, and it ultimately destroyed his career. Good for you, Larry. Hopefully you can have a happy homosexual retirement.
Let me be clear. I am not gay. I never have been gay.
While I may not have shared my wiener with the world or played footsie with an undercover cop in the Minneapolis airport bathroom, I still find myself in a bit of dilemma and making excuses, none of which that are particularly productive. Luckily, our boy Tony Robbins has 9 solutions for me to stop making excuses. Instead of focusing on all nine, I want to focus on just a couple. First one I want to focus on is shift your perspective. My perspective with this podcast, I would say, has been flawed. My perspective is, what am I doing? What is it building towards? Where am I going with it? What is the purpose of all this? Nobody watches, I'm not making any money, boo-hoo. That is not productive. I think if I were to shift my perspective and think more about my podcast and about what I can gain from it, that could help me out a lot. This article says, life is happening for you, not to you. I'm upset with my podcast because I feel like it's somehow putting me in a tough situation, making my schedule more congested or whatever, but I'm the one that's making it that way. I'm the one that's deciding to do this podcast. And I think if I were to realize that it does a lot of good for me and I can make it do even more good for me by allowing me to be creative, allowing me to be my own version of myself and be unique with having a podcast, there's a lot of concrete benefit that can come from my podcast. There's a lot of concrete benefit I've already gained from my podcast, whether it's working through a problem or having an interesting guest on or whatever else. It's done a lot of good for me. So if I were to sort of just change the way I look at it, I could get even more positives out of it and maybe even make it even better. Define your vision is another point he mentions, and this is something that I could really would help me sort of focus moving forward, because like I said, I don't know what I'm doing with this podcast and I get frustrated with that. So if I were to take time to really create a blueprint for what I want to do going forward and the sort of the angle or the what I want this podcast to become, that could help me stay more motivated and stay more true to the vision of this podcast. And he finishes with the classic duo of set goals and get support. I'm lucky enough to have bountiful support around me from my family and friends and whoever else and that support me in this podcast. Whether or not they watch it, it doesn't matter. They still support me. And that's incredible. As for setting goals, that's something that I can really work on even beyond my podcast. I could do a better job of that just even in life. I'm in this sort of decision point and my podcast is frustrating me. So if I were to sit down and set some concrete goals that I want to accomplish for my podcast, say in the next 104 weeks, that could potentially keep me much more dedicated and motivated and stick much more true to my podcast if I have a vision moving forward and some sort of path to follow. That could possibly help me just stay much more on top of things and just keep me more motivated and going with my podcast. Although I like to create this sort of dilemma or sticky situation for myself, it's really not that big of a deal. It's just a podcast I do for fun that I am kind of every now and then kind of get tired of. But when I get tired of it, I gotta remember it does a lot of good for me. And not only does a lot of good for me, there are some people that watch it. Some people do enjoy it. Some people look forward to hearing about what I have to say. Whether it's profound or not, they still watch it. Even if it's just 10 or 30 people, somebody watches it. And that means something. And if you're one of those people, I really appreciate you. Now, we've talked about my situation, my frustration, other people's excuses, some famous excuses. I think going forward, I need to do my best to stop making excuses because they don't really help anything, especially me. They just make me more frustrated, make my life a little harder, or halt me in the forward progress I'm making in my young life. Good news is, I don't think I'm going to stop this podcast anytime soon, at least for the foreseeable future. So I'm not going anywhere. While I may be frustrated now, this too shall pass and I'll be happy in a couple weeks and maybe I'll be frustrated a couple weeks later, but that's okay. We keep moving. But that is all for this week's episode of the Procrastinate Podcast. I've been your host, Matt B. Stein. You have been fantastic as always, of course. And I'll see you in next week's episode of the Procrastinate Podcast, episode 105. But for now, peace out. I actually talked to my mom earlier today about the thought of quitting my podcast, and she had some interesting thoughts on the matter.
I think that your story hasn't ended yet. Mm. You know, this what I've watched you do is grow so much over the last 102 podcasts, and I think that it needs an ending. If that's your getting a job, like, this is where I started. I was just learning about myself, and I have the job, this is my next step. Your story needs a beginning, a middle, and an end, I think. But I'm a storyteller by profession, so I look at that way. But the other part is, I'm really looking forward to talking to you in 20 years, and so you can look back. You said one point in your podcast that you looked forward to looking back at what Matthew thought when he was, you know, what was Matthew thinking in 2020? And so I think that will be interesting for you to be able to go back and look at it and cringe or not cringe, or be, you know, and show it to your kids someday, because you said that. You said someday my kids would enjoy seeing this. So I think all of that is cool, and why not continue? The other thing I guess I'd say is that I think you've learned a lot about yourself, and a lot of the podcasts, you know, it's one of the few ways, as you've been in college, I've been able to follow what you're thinking and how what you're doing. And for me, I think you're learning a lot about yourself in the process, and finding a job is hard. And being able to talk it all out once a week, even if it's 10 minutes, I think is good for you. I'm so proud of you. When you started this, you were so young, and I didn't know if you were going to do a second one. But I'm glad that you did. And I think you have a lot more to learn through the process of doing podcasting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've seen in the last 3 podcasts, it's so much better. The editing's better. The things you've added are better. You're not done learning from this project yet.
Cool. Thank you, Mom.
You're welcome.